How does it feel to be here at Showmasters Collectormania, Milton Keynes?
It feels so good to be here. I've already had so many nice people come up to me. I love coming to these events. You have such like cool, charismatic, nice, fun people. It's great. And there's also loads of photos of me all over the place. So as a narcissist, it's great.
Why do you think the show's become the global phenomenon that it has?
Well, five seasons in now, we've kind of had a fairly consistent high quality of kind of character development. I think that's definitely one of the most intimate aspects of the show that people enjoy. But it's also, I mean, there's dragons and there's CGI and there's White Walkers and there's Faith Militant and Freaks. So I think it catches the reality and the fantasy kind of concoction is just perfectly blended, really. So I think that would probably be it.
Can you talk about the physical and emotional transformation that your character went through on season 5?
Yes, it was quite a change to come back to. Physically, it was very different. I came back and I was a bit heavier. I was a bit stockier, a bit more beefy. I had to put on a little bit of weight and put on a little bit of muscle to have this more of a physical presence than necessarily he has, as I understand in the books. I know that he comes back typically a little bit more kind of shrieked and shrunk and sort of, you know, weak. But in the story this season, it's more about the impact of him coming back and being a totally revolutionized human being, and I think part of that needed him to have some sort of physical and even violent presence, which was symbiotic with being a little bit bigger. Also, the physical transformation, he's got no hairs. These aspects in his personality of sort of debasement and total total disregard for any sense of vanity, completely contrary to the past to the first two seasons. So, and then of course, namely the scar that he has tattooed on his forehead, which is the symbol of his commitment to the Faith Militant and the a new kind of world order that I think that they're trying to bring into this very, very impoverished kingdom. So, in a word, massive.
Talk about how they gave you that scar, because I believe that they scared you a little bit with your head cast.
Oh, they did. Yeah, I did. I got the head cast, and I thought they give me a head cast because they might be about to chop off my head. They're just not telling me. I thought maybe there's some undercover conspiracy here to kill me without me even knowing. I hope not. But no, it was pretty. You're in it. You just got two nose slits, and that's it. You're just there going for about 20 minutes. The guy that carved it into my head, the sweet guy that was actually filming it, went at the end, he was a Scouse guy, and he went, "Are you all right? That looked like it was really, really painful. Are you okay?" And I went, "I'm fine, mate, I'm fine." But it looked real. It looked real. The blood always does. For season 5, I particularly found, I'm trying to flash back to my memories and see, I found in the first episode, I remember I watched it and just, I totally wasn't expecting that guy's throat to get slit. I thought he was just going to have a nap and that was it. And then suddenly this knife comes out of nowhere and it really, I was very vocal in my shock. It surprised me. I think it's totally natural and very right that people have a pretty shocked reaction to something as unpleasant as the idea behind what happened to Sansa. I totally agree with the idea that we should definitely have a very, very a great deal of sensitivity towards that kind of subject matter. The only thing that I think is important about that particular scene and why I believe that it was necessary and relevant is that we are telling the story in a fantasy world, but it is based within a medieval setting, and quite simply during that time the situation of women in social society was not that high. It was a patriarchal society, and what happens to Sansa is a very unfortunate, very unpleasant reality of what could have been the case during medieval moments in any nation's history. And therefore I think it's important that is the status of women at that time is shown to be what it was at the time compared to what it is today, and the improvements that we're socially making to not let anything like a society become anything like that, all the people in it. So I think it was important to have it, but obviously viscerally unpleasant, and it's very right that people react with shock to it.
Which characters' journeys have interested you the most in the past season?
I really have enjoyed, I just always enjoy Bronn's storyline. I think he's a real traveller. I think I view him quite kind of, him and Tyrion got on so well because even though they do what they can to survive, I think he's got quite a good sense of, he has some morals to him. He goes with Jaime because even though he's going to get paid for it, maybe he kind of wants to see what's going to happen with their story, you know, with a with their finding their daughter. You know, he's got an intimate understanding of just how flawed the characters in the Seven Kingdoms are, and or in King's Landing are. And there's something about him that I think's intrigues him. He's not just a sellsword. He's a bit more layered than that.
What are you hoping for from the future? Obviously, I know George is tight-lipped on things.
Yeah, he's very tight-lipped. As he should be. I'm not hoping for any. I have no specific aspirations. I have no fear of dying. If I am going to die, then I hope it's just he dies well. Or I hope he doesn't die at all. I've no real. Haven't really given it much thought at all. I just want to. Whatever they give me, I love. Whatever they give me. I love this past season. I thought it was great for Lancel and for the story that we're telling about the people and the Faith Militant. I was very, very happy with it. So whatever comes my way, I will be a happy fella.
Things are looking not so rosy for Cersei at the moment. Is that something that we're going to see continue, do you think?
she got it coming. She got it coming. It's been a long time. I think that you need to look forward to a fairly elaborate sense of her fall. A fairly elaborate plan behind her demise is something that you should try to look forward to. Of that, I'll leave it at that.
Do you have a message to Thrones fans watching this all around the world?
I'm so grateful to you guys. I'm thrilled that you have been watching and sticking with the show for 5 seasons. It's a pleasure to have you, and I hope you continue to enjoy the show.